Hi, this is Jeff Bowler. I'm a program manager on the Intune product group, and this session is Intune for Education Troubleshooting. So in this session, we're going to review four different areas. We'll first review common issues. We'll talk about tools that are available for troubleshooting, how do you collect logs in Windows, and then also additional resources. All right, let's take a look at some issues that you may run into related to enrollment. If you're using bulk enrollment, if your provisioning package installation fails during out-of-box experience, you want to check on a few things. First of all, that the version of Windows 10 is 17.03 or above, and that the device that you're installing the provisioning package on is the same version. In addition, you want to make sure that you have internet connectivity. If you don't have internet connectivity on the device you're installing the provisioning package on, it will fail. And then you also want to make sure that the provisioning package token hasn't expired. Remember, when we created the provisioning package, it has a 30-day expiration time frame. Now, for self-serve enrollment, you want to make sure that also you have good internet connectivity. And you can verify that by just opening up a browser and connecting to a public internet website. In addition, you want to make sure that you have the correct account and password to sign in. You can validate in Azure AD to make sure that the user exists and also that they're licensed for Intune for Education. Now let's look at some common issues related to settings and applications not reaching the device. First of all, you want to ensure that the settings and applications that are assigned, that they're assigned to the appropriate group. And that's really easy to check. You can go ahead and go into groups and then look at the different settings and applications that have been assigned. In addition, for applications, you can go into apps and take a look at that specific app and look at the different groups that it's been assigned. In addition, you want to make sure that you wait a sufficient amount of time for those applications and settings to come down. And you can also have the option to do a remote sync from the Intune and Azure portal, and then also from the Windows device itself. And then you also want to check to make sure that there's no settings in the settings error report. So now let's take a look at some tools that are available for you. The first tool is called the Troubleshooting Portal, and it's a valuable tool that help desk staff and Intune administrators can use to assist them in troubleshooting Intune for Education. There's two ways that you can get to the Troubleshooting Portal. You can get to the Troubleshooting Portal through portal.azure.com and go into the Intune Blade. And then you can also go into it through the link of aka.microsoft/Intune Troubleshooting. Now let's take a walkthrough for troubleshooting. We're now in the Intune and Azure portal in the Troubleshoot Blade. And so the first step in using the Troubleshoot Blade is to select the user. And we'll select this user, Jess KL. And once we select this user, we're able to find information about the user, their account name, their email address, that they're licensed for Intune, that their device is compliant, the different groups that they are members of. We also see the number of applications that they've been assigned, and a listing of the devices that they've enrolled. In addition, we can take a look at the different settings that have been applied to them, and here we can see that we have one setting policy that's been applied. Let's go ahead and select one of the devices that this user has enrolled. Once we do that, we find some information about the device, the operating system, the last time it checked in. We can also look at detailed hardware and information. And even discovered applications that are on the device. If we wanted to take a remote action on this device, we would select Overview. And here we can remove the company data from the device. This is like an unenrollment. We can do a factory reset of the device. If we select More, we can also do a remote sync and a restart of the device itself. So the Troubleshoot Blade is a very useful application to use when you're troubleshooting Intune for Education. Now let's go back to the slides. The next section we'll look at for troubleshooting is log collection. Now, you may run into situations where you'll have to call Microsoft support and work with Microsoft support. And one of the things that they may ask is for you to collect the Intune for Education logs on the Windows device. And collecting logs is very easy to do. You go into Settings, under Accounts, and Access Worker School. And then you also select the Export Your Management Log Files. And when you do that, the log files will be saved in your C drive under Users, Public, Public Documents, under MDM, Diagnostics. And then you can take those files, those log files, and send them to Microsoft support to further investigate the issue. Let's now take a look at some additional resources that are available for you. The first is Intune Service Health in the Office 365 Admin Center. So you can check the status of Intune service and also view Intune service messages in the Office 365 Admin Center. In addition, you can take a look at this information in the Office 365 Admin mobile application, and I have a link there to go ahead and click on. And this application runs both on iOS, Android, and Windows Phone. Microsoft provides free support for Intune for Education, whether it's a trial subscription or a paid subscription. And there's more information about Intune support at the link provided on this slide. I provided some additional information related to Intune for Education troubleshooting. First of all, there's a link to general troubleshooting tips for Microsoft Intune and Intune for Education. There's a link to Intune User Voice, which is a site that you can make feature recommendations and report bugs. There's the Intune forum to discuss questions and issues that you may have. And then there's a link to Intune support. This now concludes the Intune for Education troubleshooting session.